upright on two legs. The snake said at that time. Till God cursed him and he had to go about on his belly the rest of the days of his life. But he walked upright and he could speak. So I'm sure that Eve was fascinated by this animal. She had never seen anything like this beautiful snake. You may not know this, but snakes are really pretty. May not like them. They may be poison, some of them. But if you look at them, they're very beautiful. The color and things that God ingrained into his character. Okay, read.
Yea, hath God said, ye shall not eat of every tree of the garden.
Listen, right there, he's misstating the truth. He's asking, he's giving a statement, part question. He said, have not God said, now you're going to tell him what God said. Have not God said you can eat of every tree of the garden? God never said that. He said, thou mayest eat of all the trees freely that's in the garden, but of that one tree that's in the midst of the garden, that one tithe, that tenth, you cannot touch it. Did y'all hear what I just said there? The tithe is not yours. It belongs to God. You're supposed to not spend the tithe. You're supposed to give it to the church, which is giving it to Jesus, and hope that they're doing the right thing with it. Am I right about it?
Amen.
So that one tree was the tithe, I say today. But God is saying, don't touch that tree, that physical tree in the garden. That's the one that has mischief with it. That's the one that can get you in trouble. But right now, she's listening to whose voice? Satan, the third voice, that outside voice. Go ahead.
And the woman said unto the serpent, we may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden.
She's in a conversation with the devil. Go ahead.
But of the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden.
She pointed out the tree now. He didn't even know where it was at.
God had said, ye shall not eat of it, neither shall you touch it.
Now, God never said anything about touching it. He said you're not to eat of it. But common sense tells you that to eat of it, you got to touch it. She added more in there. Because at this point, she's getting confused. Go ahead.
Lest ye die. And the serpent said unto the woman, ye shall not surely die. For God doth know that in the day ye eat thereof, then your eyes shall be opened, ye shall be as gods, knowing good and evil.
Now listen right here. Isn't that very appealing? If someone told you, if you eat this fruit, you're going to become like God. That's what he said essentially. Yeah. You're going to become like God, knowing good and evil. That was a part truth. Because when she ate of it, she did for the first time know good and evil. She didn't even know she was naked. Because the Shekinah glory of God is what covered them at that time. Mm-hmm. But sin made them naked.
Right.
Sin uncovered them. Mm-hmm. That's why later on you'll see after they sinned, the Bible says they hid themselves mm-hmm. in the fig leaves in the garden. Because of shame. Shame will make you cover up.
Yeah.
Shame and guilt will hover you down because you did not get it right. Because mm-hmm. you didn't get the instructions right. We have to get the instructions yes. right. You got to follow the manual if you're going to pass the NBA test. Mm-hmm. You can't just say, well, I'm going to study this book over here and not prepare for the test and think you're going to pass the test. You have to study the manual book that pertains to the test you're about to go take.
Yes.
And another thing, students, don't think that if you've been out all night long partying and you haven't read nothing for the test you know coming tomorrow, don't think you can pray to God and he's going to show some kind of mercy and help you pass the test. You got to study, glory to God. The Bible says, study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. It's work when you study the Bible, but it's worthwhile work. And the pay is eternal life. Write that down. Hallelujah. Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
Did you finish reading?
No, verse 6.
Uh-huh.
And when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was pleasant to the eyes.
When she saw, with them physical eyes. Uh-huh.
And a tree to be desired to
start again. And when she saw, right there.
Okay.
When the woman saw.
And when the woman saw that the tree was good for
uh-huh.
food.
Uh-huh. For food, that food thing is a distraction to God.
And that it was a pleasant to the eyes.
Pleasant to the eyes, them eyeballs.
And a tree to be desired to make one wise.
Oh, pride, damn.
She took off the fruit thereof and did eat. And gave also unto her husband with her, and he did eat.
Listen, if she only knew the damage she was doing to millions of generations, she would have never ate of that fruit. She thought about the now like most of us do. She didn't think about the future. You know something God been opening up my eyes to? Almost everything I say and I do is not just for me and for now. You're influencing something to happen in your family. Because death and life are in the power of the tongue. In the voice of the tongue. And what you say is what you'll have. The Bible says you'll have whatsoever you say. Mm-hmm. I heard Mary when she said, be it unto me mm-hmm. according to what? Thy word. Yeah. Thy word is forever settled in the heavens. Words are powerful.
Oh, yeah.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue. But they come in the form of a voice. John the Baptist was referred to as one that cried in the wilderness. The voice crying in the wilderness. He was the voice of God on earth.
Amen.
Preaching what God was saying from heaven. Mm-hmm. That's what an ambassador does. Mm-hmm. When he goes to another country, he or she represents the president right. or kings of that particular
right.
country.
Right.
And she only speaks what that king has told her to speak. Mm-hmm. Only sticks to it. Mm-hmm. She is a representative of that particular mm-hmm. country and of that king and that queen. That's what angels do. Mm-hmm. When they come with a message from heaven, they don't speak what comes to their mind. Mm-hmm. They only are assigned, not programmed like a robot, because they can speak what they want to if they chose to, but they love God and fear God so much that they only speak what God said to speak
right.
and preach what God tells them to preach. And that's the way we should be.
Mm-hmm.
We should be able to get through the emotion and all the other things that bother us and have troubled us during the week
mm-hmm.
and get a clear pathway to God so we can hear what thus saith the Lord and speak what thus saith the Lord only and not what our emotions
yes,
tell us to speak.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's very powerful.
Yeah.
Did you finish?
Yes, that was
okay, good. Give me John. First John. Somebody real quick. Let me give you a name.
John?
Yeah, real quick. Second chapter. When she saw that the fruit was good for food and desired to be made one wise, she ate of the fruit. She ate of the fruit. I said she ate of the fruit.
Yeah.
Anyhow, because now she's knee deep in it now.
Verse 1.
She had already been it now. Verse number 2. I mean chapter 2. 1 John 2:15. Somebody read that.
2:15.
Love not the world.
Uh-huh.
Neither the things that are in the world.
Uh-huh.
And if any man love the world,
uh-huh.
the love of the Father is not in him.
Now listen to this. All that is in the world. Read it, son.
Oh. Love not the world, neither the things that are in the world. If any man love the world, the love of the Father is not in him.
Listen to this. All that is in the world.
The lust of the flesh.
Uh-huh.
And the lust of the eyes.
Uh-huh. Did she see the food? It was good to be food?
Mm-hmm.
And this ties right into that. The lust of the flesh. She wanted that food. Now, before I got saved, I was taught there was an apple. The Bible don't say that. We don't know that. But it was good for food, the Bible said.
Mm-hmm.
The lust of her flesh moved her to bite that apple. Sometimes we go through the same process when it's time to eat something. We eat stuff we know we shouldn't eat. But the lust of the flesh gets you again, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I'm the first one to put my hand up.
Yes.
But the lust of the flesh, what's the next one?
The lust of the eyes.
The lust of the eyes. See, she saw, remember, that it was good for food. Go ahead.
And the pride of life.
Pride of life. There it is. All in a row. Go ahead.
Is not the Father, but is of the world.
It's not of the Father, it says. Not the Father. It says not of the Father. Am I right?
Mm-hmm.
That's important. I know what it says. It is not of the Father. It's not of God, is what it's saying. So she did something that was not of God. But it's of the world, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then it tells you a little further. Keep reading.
The world passes away,
and the lust thereof, but he that doeth the will of the Father, go ahead.
Abideth forever.
She was abiding outside of the will of God when she took and ate of that fruit. But let's go a little further. Let's look at 3:8-13 of Genesis. Stay there in 3rd chapter of Genesis. 8-13. Satan was very tricky. He came to the woman. He didn't come to the man who originally got the commandment from the mouth of God. He went to the woman, evidently, who got it indirectly from her husband. Don't you know most of the time when you tell somebody something, by the time it gets to the second person, it changes a little bit? Try it. Speak something and go through about 3 more people. And I guarantee you, by the time it gets to that fifth or sixth person, it's nothing near what you say yet. He went to the one he knew that didn't get the direct command from God. He went to the woman.
Mm-hmm.
But the sad part about it, we can read about this here. Because for years I was told that the man was somewhere off where he should have been right there. But the Bible tells us he was right there. Mm-hmm. He was not off somewhere. Read 3:8. Anybody?
And they heard the voice of the Lord, God walking in the garden.
Okay, go back to 7. I want to see something here. Read 7 for me.
And the eyes of them both were open.
Both. That means he was right there. I just caught that for the first time. I just caught that now. the eyes of them both. That means he was right there. I always looked at the scriptures, the part of the scriptures, Greg, come up, that she gave to eat with her. I always looked at that, because that says he was right there. Mm-hmm. But there it says the eyes of them both. I know what happens, I've never seen that before. Yeah. Read that, but never seen it before. The eyes of them both. You had to be there for your eyes to open. Go ahead.
And they knew that they were naked.
They knew they were naked. Uh-huh.
And they sewed fig leaves together and made them.
They became artistic, the best seamstresses in the world now. They had hidden talents, didn't even know it till they sinned. Sin will bring out talents you don't know you got. You didn't know you could dance like that till you backslide and went back there to the club. Now you're doing jerks and stuff you ain't never done before. Look like two white boys with your hair swinging, smoking marijuana. Jumping up and down. Everything is